Anyway, so with that we will continue to the next topic. Word count is what we just finished. So we will now see the commands head and tail. Yeah. So in this particular directory, we have these various files. Let us see this bigger. Yeah. So first line is what? Programming Perls, C programming language, Mythical Man Month. Some first three lines. Perhaps we are interested in only the first three lines. Yeah. So why don't we see just head, bigger? It will show us only few lines. Is it showing the first three lines only? No, it didn't know that we are interested only in three lines. Why don't we give a option minus n three bigger? So now it has shown us only the first three lines. This fourth line that you see here is a continuation of this line. So this is just because we have made the font sizes very large, and hence actually it's showing only three lines. It is easier to see for when you choose option 2 and shows only two lines. That is very important. For example, I'll tell you what. For those in IIT also, we are running this course, and when we do partial marking, we see each person's code. If the code is completely correct, then what we do is we just see that this guy has got full marks because his code has got executed correctly. Yeah, executed fully correctly is what we can check by using another script. But then for those who are doing partial marking, there for each code we open and see. Now do we have to write the pen on paper separate that this person has to get so many marks? No, we wrote it on the first line as a comment. Yeah, on the first line we wrote this person has got so many marks. This is the reason for not giving full mark. By partial marking, he got only half mark, 50-60% of the marks for that question. We wrote that in the first line. Then we wrote a bash script that extracts out the first line for every code, for every student's code. That way in one list we have roll number, code, roll number marks. Yeah. So this is how head command is extremely useful. In one go we can extract out just the first line, or just first, or just second line, just first 10 lines. What about last 10 lines? What about tail, the last two lines, tail minus n bigger? Yeah, this extracts out the tail of the file. Yeah, so please note, these all have to be regular text files. They should not be PDF file or something. Somebody had asked a question about PDF file, how that opens in events, etc. We will come back to that question, but please note, head, tail, cut, cat, less will all work for plain text files only. These are the only files we will be writing in bash scripts, LaTeX, Python. All these files we will write just plain text files. To write the files, we will use some very simple editors. We will not be using OpenOffice, etc., even though they are open source. We are going to be using plain text editors, about which we will cover tomorrow. So tail is a command for seeing the last few lines of a file. Minus f is also an extremely important option in tail. Now what is this tail minus f? It will always keep showing the last few lines, and it will not come back to the command prompt. Yeah. So notice that here when we did tail minus 2 bigger.txt, it has shown the last two lines of bigger.txt and come back to the prompt. This is our command line interface. Yeah, this is where we are typing all the commands. Unlike when you do less minus n less bigger.txt, it is showing screenful by screenful, but it is not come back to the command prompt. Yeah, it is waiting for you to press slash and search for a pattern, etc. It has not come to the command prompt, importantly. So now of course we have gone to the last line and it has said end. It has said end, and end we see that last two lines are indeed what tail command was showing. Yeah. So if you are interested in only the last line, do we have to each time start less and then go to the end? Yeah. Do we have to really do that, and then we have to anyway press a space bar to come out to the prompt? Yeah, or press Q. So in my less, I have configured that when you press space bar, you will come out. Also, you can also configure that as soon as the last screenful is shown, it will come back to the command prompt. That is also possible to set in less. But if you are interested in only the last two lines anyway, or let's say last 10 lines, tail minus n 10 bigger. Yeah, so it has shown the last 10 lines. Just tail bigger. that's also showing some number of lines. I think the default is 20. Do help tail, and it will tell you when you don't give an option minus n something, it has some default number of lines which it will show. If you are interested in a more specific number of lines, then minus n, that number is what you should be doing. But importantly, it has come back to the command prompt. So what is tail minus f now? Tail minus f is very useful for monitoring. Yeah. So it is showing the last this many lines. As I said, default for something. Why don't we see how many lines? Minus n. Let's say 3 lines. Sometimes the options have to be given as separate hyphens. Yeah. So tail minus n 3 meaning last 3 lines is what we are saying, and we are doing minus f, and then the file name of course. So what is this? That has not come back to the command prompt. Yeah. Why minus f option has made it keep showing the last 3 lines. Yeah. What is, why keep showing? Because some other program might append something to the bottom, and that time the last 3 lines might change. Yeah, we can, I will show you how we can, while the bigger.txt file is only being monitored, tail head less cat will never modify a file. It will only read a file, it will keep reading. This tail command is used for monitoring, it will keep reading, and if you append this file by adding another line, yeah, at the same time, surprisingly, while you are monitoring this file, you can go stealthily, you can go from the backside to another terminal and modify this file and append some line to this file. Let us see what happens. So here you do not have to worry about what I am typing here. Yeah, this is just to make my prompt a little smaller. Now we are going to, yeah, how do you another line added. The purpose of what I am typing here is only to append another line to that bigger.txt file. Yeah. Why this particular command is precisely appending another line to bigger.txt file, this particular reason we will see later in this course, tomorrow only. Yeah. So please don't ask doubts about this particular part now. What this does is, another line added, this particular line is going to get appended to the end of bigger.txt. Yeah, it has successfully done that. Let's go back here. Look here. Yeah, so now this new line has got added. Huh? So that I got, that came because I pressed I by mistake. We can append this again. We are stealthily going to another terminal and appending. So here it has again changed. Yeah. So this tail minus f is extremely useful for monitoring a file, regularly going on opening and seeing a line, seeing a file, and it is beneficial for that. So how do you quit out of that? Because it's sitting and monitoring, we want to come back to the command prompt, control C to interrupt. Yeah. So this is our notation, control C. Please note that this C does not mean capital C. Just control C is what you type to interrupt anything, control C for cancel. That C is not capital. Yeah, this is our notation. Allows cut. Cut is extremely important command, very useful. You all know cut, paste, copy, paste, very important. But then this is not cut using a mouse. Yeah, this is from the prompt, from the command line, we are going to type a command to cut a particular line, to cut and remove a particular statement, particular column. In every line, one particular column is what we will pick. What does this do? So let us take an example. Let us see bar. Uh, I am looking for an example, let us say marks, yeah. So, here is an example of some marks, some data files from which we want to copy, we want to cut a particular column. Yeah, let us see another example. Here are some names. So, let us see this marks 1 dot text. Yeah, it has a marks, for example, for each student, these are the various marks of the first student, some name might be sitting in another file. These are the marks of the second student, marks of the third student, yeah. This might be the marks of the first test, yeah. You all also will undergo many tests, and we are going to store all the information, all the marks, not in Microsoft Excel, not even in open office spreadsheet. Why? Because these are just some plain marks, we are going to add them at most, we will save them in plain TXT file, yeah. How to generate that, all that we will see soon. But now, suppose we are interested in marks only in the third test. First column is first test, second column is second test, third column is third test. We are interested in removing out the marks of only the third test of all the people. So, from every line we want to extract out the third column, that is when cut is extremely helpful. What are we going to do? Cut minus D, yeah. So, what does this mean? D for delimiter, yeah. How are your various columns separated? They are separated by spaces. How should this cut command know that in your particular data file, in your marks1.txt, you are picking up the third column? Third column is specified by minus F3, yeah. But that third column, how are you distinguishing first column, second column, third column? How are these delimited? What is a delimiter? What separates the first and second column? Yeah, we know in our file it is space, yeah. And as I said, space is very important. After all, cut and minus D also has a space. So, how do you tell that this is a space literally? So, in software engineering, we had shown that you take double quotes and then immediately the space is taken literally. So, here also we will specify cut minus D space minus F3. After you say the delimiter, that is when you are able to say third column with respect to the delimiter. First one, whatever occurs before the first space is automatically first column. What occurs before the first space is first column. If there is only one space in a line, then there are automatically two columns. Yeah, when we do this, yeah, so let us check that we have indeed got the third column. What were the marks? Cat, we have shown the entire marks1.txt. This is our third column. Third column indeed has come out, yeah, we have cut and removed the third column. This is how we have done that, yeah. We can say not just first, not just third, third and fourth, yeah, we will show third and fourth, yeah. We might say we will cancel off one quiz, yeah. Why? Because questions were very ambiguous, questions are not written properly, so that quiz should not have been taken into account. We want to remove out that entire column. Suppose quiz number 2 was not well drafted, so we will take only first, third and fourth columns now, yeah. So, this is how, check that it has removed the second column precisely. We might say take second to last. Now, are we supposed to count how many columns and count the last column? No, yeah. If you want everything between in the middle anyway, you can say second dash. That will say second onwards up to the last, yeah. So, these all options are certainly there in this. So, why do not we go back to the slides and see, yeah. So, cut is extremely important. Anybody who has a doubt, please ask right away. Good, there is a question from Mufakamja College, Hyderabad. Please ask your question now.
When we give a command minus F, we can append the line in a particular file.
So, our question is that how to in the tail command there was this minus f option. Minus f option I said was for monitoring a file. So how to save the output or how to save the appended line? Anyway, that line has got appended to bigger.txt file. Bigger.txt file is a new file now which has another line. Which another line? The last line is another line added. Yeah, the file has already changed. It's already saved there. Tail minus f is just showing. It's only monitoring. It's not modifying the file, not editing. It is just showing. Yeah. So that answers the question. I understand. I guess. Okay. Please, from IMCC Pune, please ask your question.
Hello sir, you have directly said us how to cut and how to get the third column and fourth column, but you did not say how to create that file exactly.
Yeah, so the question from IMCC Pune was that we didn't even create that file for you. We are going on giving these demos of how to cut, paste, all this. You don't have any file to test. There's no file as of now. How will you copy? What cut will you do? Yeah, very reasonable question. Yeah, so that is why this example here has been, let's go back to the slide. This example here has been showing this etc password. Yeah, see, please go to your computer and look at this particular file slash etc slash password. Don't be concerned, nobody's password is visible there. Yeah, in Linux, Unix, no password is anyway written on that, it is not visible. It is stored in some really complicated way. Only I think those few developers know how to infer that information. Don't worry about it. Just go to that line and see that some such long line is there. Some very repeated, every line this colon will come. Yeah, this colon is separating some two important things. You can use delimiter colon and do it. The slides are drafted far more wisely than how I am teaching. They have kept note that look, users will not have marks1.txt file. We will teach you how to do all this. Very soon we will learn how to pipe, etc., and create such files systematically. ls minus l will already create some file. We will answer those questions after we take a question from Maulana Azad, NIT Bhopal. Please ask your question now.
Good evening, sir. I am Dr. Tomar from NIT Bhopal. Is it possible to calculate the length of a line in a particular text file?
So the question from MANIT Bhopal is, how do you check the number of characters in a line, just the first line or 10th line? How do you check precisely the 10th line and how many characters are there on that line? As of now, I know one method that is not the shortest method, I am sure. There would certainly be good, far more powerful one line codes rather than long, long commands. So we will see that. Suppose you want to do head minus n 1, yeah, of bigger bigger.txt. Here is this line. We have not yet taught you how to pipe it, yeah, but why don't we go ahead and pipe it? This says there are 19 characters on that one line. Yeah, it says that whatever was given as output to WC, that had only one line, then there were two words on that and there were 19 characters. If you, how to use this pipe, we will teach you tomorrow. Yeah, please bear with us. We appreciate that you are so curious, you are asking questions which we will cover only tomorrow. Thank you very much for this. Until tomorrow is all we are asking you to wait. Okay, so any other question? How can we convert text file into PDF? Yeah, so if you write the text file as RST file, then this is a yes. Okay, so one of the questions from SDES ITS is how can we convert text file into PDF? So let's continue with cut. But now as a genuine complaint has come that marks1.txt file is not available, let us see this slash etc slash password. There is this slash etc slash password on every Linux computer. So there are all these so many, yeah, and this colon is separating everything. Now this is how it is on my computer. So what we can do on every line, anyway there is a colon, slash etc slash password is after all generated by the computer. It would definitely have some good syntax. So why don't we look at second column with what delimiter? With the colon delimiter. Yeah, we will see second and third. this is a file surely all of you have. Output of course will be different because my slash etc password is different from yours. So why don't you all try this? Cut minus d colon has to be told to it. If it is not space, if it is colon, for example, you don't have to put it in double quotes. Yeah. Second column of which file? Not yet told. So they all happen to be X. Yeah. Why don't we take some other? Second, comma, third, comma, fourth. Yeah. Some three things have come out. Your also will, your output also will be something similar. Now you can test the various things. Yeah, that is the first answer we can give. From second to fourth, you can use dash. Second comma third comma four is same as 2-4. 2- nothing means up to the end. Yeah, as many columns as there are. Now that is as far as using a test file is concerned. But on Moodle, there is a test underscore files dot gz dot zip, all zipped, may all the test files that we will be using again and again. So we will take a question from KJ Somaya, Mumbai. So please ask your question now.
Hello sir, as we can use cut command for extracting specific columns, using head we can get the initial rows, tail we can get the bottom rows. Is it possible to get specific rows instead of specific columns?
So the question from KJ Somaya is, cut is useful for getting the fourth column, fifth column. It's all, we are worrying so much about columns. What about rows? Suppose you want 10th row, 11th row. You see, in Linux, in any file, anyway lines are easier to extract. Yeah. Lines are first 10 lines, last 10 lines is what we have anyway done using head tail, but any 10th line, 10th, 100th, 111th line, extracting these lines are anyway easier. Yeah, they are so easy, that is why we already planned to keep it for the exam without covering it. Yeah, but now that you ask it, let us quickly see it. But then because the extracting out of specific row means specific line, because they are easier, we are not worrying about it as much as column. Yeah, in my opinion, that is an answer. Another question is how to compare two files. Yeah, we will certainly see this. Thank you for this question. But this answers the question of KJ Somaya. How do you see only the 10th row? 10th row is same as 10th line, so that is not difficult to see. So let us see it quickly. So another question is how to redirect the output of one terminal, output of the command of one terminal to another terminal. To another terminal is a little hard. To the as input to another command is easy. How to save it to another file is certainly easy, which can be read from another terminal. Yeah, one terminal to another perhaps is possible. Hard to say anything is impossible. So let us see how to see the 10th line. So let us see this bigger. There is this bigger file, rather big file. Suppose we want to see first 10 lines, head minus n 10, it is showing the 10th, first 10 lines. We are not, if you want to see the 10th line, only the 10th line if you want to see, are you forced to see, always see the first 9 lines also? Why don't we, so after you see pipe, yeah, this is showing only the 10th line. Yeah, the important thing for you to note is there is this pipe. Pipe means what? Pipe is happens on most keyboards, it happens to be just above the enter key. Yeah, so if you use pipes, then you can do all this easier. You can also do this using something called sed, SED. Now this is something I came only recently. If you use SED, then you can directly get, you can print only the 10th line. Yeah, so SED is something we will not cover, but piping one thing, output of one thing into as input to another is something we will cover, certainly cover. For those who are really curious about this, we welcome the curiosity. Please go through the slides and already the answer will be visible, it is explained in the slides. Yeah. This another question, how to cut the row from a text file, how to remove out a text file. This is also doable. This is also doable. One of the questions is from VIT Belur, na? Belur. VIT V is Belur. One of the questions from Belur is how to cut the row from a text file. How to remove only the 10th line? Yeah, 10th line perhaps is because some particular guy has got very low marks, and we are interested in sending the entire marks file to everybody, and we don't want everybody to know that this guy has got very low marks. We'll just cut out that line. Yeah, it's not hard to do it. Yeah, what to do is just get the line numbers and remove out that line which starts from 10. This is something we will do when we see grep. Yeah, grep is a command, some general regular expression command which we will use, and then you can see you can cut out, you can print all except 10th line, you can print only the 10th line also. All that is very easily possible using grep. Okay, so with this we will go to some more advanced things within cut. So cut allows choosing on the basis of characters also. Yeah, if you are interested in cutting out just the 4 characters, not using a delimiter. Yeah, they are all sort of every character location is known, and you can also use this. Dash 4 means what? Everything up to 4. 10 dash means what? 10 onwards up to the end of that line. So the default is for every line. So for example, okay, now paste. Very important, paste, after you cut we will also like to paste it. So paste takes one line of that, one line of this, and appends them line wise on the same line, 2 things will come. Yeah, so this particular line that is shown here is shown only for demonstration. It will not actually get generated by using paste. Yeah, so please don't please note that this line is not generated. Paste will do, it will get this students.txt, marks.txt, and it will put these two lines from 2 different files on the same line of the output. Yeah, this is what we will see. So paste students.txt, marks.txt. Why? Because one person might be generating the marks, one person might be writing the students. In many universities, in many colleges, it is a very nice policy is followed where the person who is checking, there is some coding going on. Yeah, so each person will write only the code number and marks, code number marks, without knowing the names. Finally, that some big person has to combine the 2 files. Yeah, how is this combining going to be done? Are we, for such a simple task, are we going to open spreadsheet? Yeah, we will not open Microsoft spreadsheet, but are we going to open Office spreadsheet for such a simple task? Yeah, so paste is the command to do. So what does the paste do? For this we need the example files. So you can try out this example after downloading test_files.zip later on after this session is over. So please pay attention to what is being done here now. So there are students here, then there are marks, sorry, these are 2 files luckily containing the same number of lines, each has 5 lines. Now we want to say, look, first line here corresponds to Hussein's marks. Next line here, this line here corresponds to Dilbert's marks. Yeah, in other words, we want to paste this beside each other. Why don't we just do paste students marks. It has put this on the screen. Yeah, it has shown this on the screen. If you want to save this to a file, what to do, we'll worry soon. But is this output acceptable? Is this what we really wanted? So these were the 2 files, and at least the last line is indeed visible. Sven, output, it has got pasted like this, and last line was indeed Sven here, and last set of marks, last line was equal to this. They have come beside each other. Yeah, that is the tougher part of the work. At least whatever is required has come correctly on the screen. Yeah, it has come on what we call standard output. Standard output is a screen. Whatever is supposed to happen has happened, but it has come on the screen. So this standard output, now to get it to go into a file is a easier task. Yeah, that is the next thing we will do. Let us see if there is anything more to do in paste. Let us go back to the slides. Yeah. So, if the first column of marks file had roll numbers, yeah, so this one can try some more advanced things. So, print, so paste will just paste the first column here, first file, second file, and put the line by line. Yeah, it says minus s option will print one line of this below the first line of that. Yeah, line by one, you may not want to append everything on the same line. Minus s option is an option for doing, as it says, one below the other. Which one below which? Yeah, the sequence you can check, that the sequence in which you give the arguments is important. Paste command requires two arguments, two input arguments, one file, another file. Of course, you can take 3-4 more files also, at least two are required. Yeah, so we already saw the output of paste command, it came on the screen. How to make this go into another file, that is the next important thing. This, for this we will use this greater than sign, yeah, extremely important in bash scripts. Whatever output you check that it is coming on the screen correctly, once you are sure it is coming on the screen correctly, you will redirect it. Yeah, greater than sign means redirect it to something else, so, redirect it to a file. Yeah, this greater than is almost suggestive of an arrow, yeah, it will get arrowed, it will get redirected to file output of paste. Yeah, choose any file name, and it is just suggestive for the purpose of explaining. So, now nothing has come on the screen. Yeah, standard, whatever had come on standard output has got redirected to file underscore output one some long underscore, some file name we gave. Are we sure it has done that? Why do not we do cant? Yeah. So, I encourage all of you to be very suspicious of any claim that I do, suspicious of any claim written in the slides, always test it. We already know how to check the contents of a file, cat. Yeah, luckily it is exactly that. Yeah, what if we do it again? It will overwrite that file. Yeah, here there is no minus I option, it will not, you cannot make it interactive mode. Do you really want to overwrite or not? All this possibility is there only for CP, MV, some such commands. All the, when it comes to this greater than sign, it expects that you are all very responsible. Overwrite is default, you cannot even disable that. Yeah, overwriting is no, it will happen. But what it will allow is, it will allow you to append to this. If the file already exists, well and good, otherwise it will, if the file exists, it will append to that file. If the file does not exist, then it will create that file. So, this particular double arrow means, yeah, so now we can check. So, it has, that same output has got created two times. First time, of course, it created the file up to here. After this much was created, again the same output, yeah, incidentally it was same, in general it could be different. Same output got appended to that existing file. Yeah, so double arrow means append, double arrow will also create the file if it does not exist, single arrow will create the file. If the file already exists, it will overwrite, certainly there is no way to disable it. Please use this very, very carefully. So, we know that how output of this paste, default the output comes on the screen, screen means monitor means standard output, yeah, STDOUT. In various commands you will see that the output goes to STDOUT, all capital. Yeah, let us see if it is supposed to be a shell variable, let us see what it is. No, there is no variable in it, but this STDOUT means standard output, that is default the monitor. If you do not want the output to come to the standard output, you can use greater than sign, that will direct it to a file. Double arrow mark means it will append it to that file, if that file exists. If that file does not exist, it will still create that file. Okay, so now let us come to some more command shell features. So, we will see the use of the pipe command. Yeah, so redirect we have already seen. Pipe is an extremely important thing that we will see now. So cat, this is the output, suppose this output, whatever has come on the screen, yeah, whatever has come on the screen in general, from this screen we want to run another command. For example, we want to remove the second column, yeah, we want to remove the second column from where, why do not we do this. So, we already saw the paste command, that is why we are doing this. Notice that there is no greater than sign. Maybe we are doing all these operations sitting in somebody in some directory where we do not have write permissions, yeah. So, it comes on the screen that much, because we have read permission, we can paste these two files and output of the paste is coming on the screen. Coming on the screen, we do not need any permission, there is no chmod or anything required for showing the output of some command on the screen. But maybe we want to run some further operation on this, maybe from this we want to extract out this particular column, yeah. If you want to extract out this particular column, or we want to extract out only the first column, so why do not, so ideally we would like to use cut, so cut minus d. Minus F1, yeah. So, let me just explain what this is doing. So, please see only this part now. How does this part work? Cut delimiter space. Once you have decided the delimiter, all the columns are well defined, yeah. Now, you have to say first column. After that, how did the cut command work? It required the file name. Yeah, I mean, if you want to use cut command, you are supposed to say the file name over which is supposed to act, but now we did not specify any file name, but still it has worked. How did that happen? Whatever file name it is supposed to take, that has been fed in from the backdoor entry, yeah, that is like pipe. So, let us call it dash. Dash is not a file actually, but it will help later on when we use paste, it will certainly help there. So, we did not specify file name. If you did not specify anything, but you are giving that information, how are we giving that information? That one is coming from here, yeah. So please pay a lot of attention to this part. Pipe, redirect, extremely important. The role that this dash plays, you will also become very important very soon. So just note that we did not specify any file name to the cut command. Yeah, delimiter, first column, all that we have specified, but we didn't specify the file name. Why? Because that is coming as output of another command, and that output, instead of going to standard output, instead of going into a file, instead of being redirected to a file, it is being carefully piped to the cut command. Yeah, I am not sure what is the best analogy for the pipe usage of the pipe symbol. It's like somebody is ill, some small dog is ill and it is not taking food, then you put a pipe and send the input to that mouth directly through the pipe. Yeah, think of it like that. As of now there is no better analogy. So, the input argument, the file, whatever is supposed to come from the file to the cut part of the command is coming through this pipe. Yeah, for earlier keyboards, the pipe symbol had a small space in the middle. Yeah, that time it was very clear that there is this hole between it through which the information comes, but then for modern keyboard somehow that part of the that small hole inside that pipe is missing. Anyway, the pipe still works exactly like a pipe, yeah. So, of course, there is only one cut requires only one file name as an argument, so there is no dash required to be given. So, this is something each one of you should check. On which file? Just take cat slash /etc slash /password, yeah, such a big file. Now, pipe it, whatever has come on the screen, pipe it to cut, cut minus d colon, yeah, and which column? Minus F2, yeah, sorry, F, I forgot. Why do not we say only first column? So, this cut underscore d, cut space d colon, this part of the command does not even have to know how that input input to this cut was generated, yeah, it happened to come from a file by cat command, but that is besides the point. This is just for example. It is coming through a pipe, that is all that matters for cut. Yeah, is this clear? We have to take questions on this now. MES, okay, good. There is a question from Kolhapur. Please ask your question now.
You just shown us the command pest then student.txt marks.txt.
Yeah.
We redirected the output using the pipe to cut hyphen d, then in the double quote space hyphen f. But I tried the command with hyphen f space 1 comma 2, then it's not showing the proper output. The columns are not getting merged properly.
Yeah. So the question from Kolhapur is that I as an instructor chose to take only one column, but if you take 1, 2 or 3 more columns, then this column formatting is not working properly, and I knew it will not work properly, that is why it took only one column. Good that you tried to take more columns and you indeed saw it is not working properly. So we will have to discuss a little more in detail. Are there any other questions meanwhile? So why don't we have a question from Nirma University, Ahmedabad? Okay, so meanwhile we will have the question from her. Mrinmay's question, who is sitting here, who is not using a mic. So let me repeat the question. Her question is, we use the greater than sign for redirect, that could have been used by cat for cat command also for concatenating multiple files. After concatenating multiple files, instead of the output coming on the screen, we could redirect that to a file. Yeah, certainly, that is exactly what I had used in the beginning when we wanted a bigger file, because we wanted to see the use of the less command. For that purpose we had used greater than sign. So concatenate actually works for that. Just for convenience, default cat commands output is coming on the screen. It is most often used to concatenate them and convert it to a file. Yeah. So thank you indeed. We'll take this question from Saint Joseph College, Kerala.
Sir, how to print multiple only selected lines multiple in a file?
So the question from Saint Joseph, Kerala is how to choose and print only the 10th, 12th, 100th line, only few lines. Not all the lines. Yeah, how to choose and print precisely those lines. So this is possible. I already showed one example. If it is only one line, then you can use a combination of head, tail and pipe. But then you can also use grep to do this. As soon as we do grep, in case I forget to address this question, please remind me. Yeah, immediately after grep is when we can certainly do this. We can do what? See only precisely some 4-5 lines which may not be consecutive. Yeah, that is what we can see immediately after we see grep. Okay, so meanwhile we can go to Nirma University, Ahmedabad.
Right, how can we cut a particular row using the cut command? Like we are cutting down the columns, right? How can we cut rows from a file?
Yeah, many people are asking how to cut only the first row, second row, how to remove it. This seems to be very urgent, we will do it right away. Yeah. So her question is, we saw how to cut and remove only the fourth column based on a particular delimiter, but we would like to know how to cut the 10th row. Yeah, 10th row means 10th line. Yeah, I should say these are easier, that is why we have not covered it, but they are important. They are certainly more important than cutting a column. So we will see that. How to cut the last two columns? Okay, so let us see how to cut this. So first question was, first important question that we did not answer was, somebody wanted to see first and second column for this particular command here, not for this, but for here, when that person pressed 1 comma 2, then it has gone wrong. Yeah, this is because there are many spaces. Yeah, each space is considered. See, in this and, there must be one space here, then there must be another space here, because of the, while here there is no space. Yeah, some multiple spaces are causing this to go wrong. Yeah, may on the screen what we are not able to see is space and tab look the same. Yeah, but if there indeed had been precisely one space, whenever you see many spaces, you don't know whether there are multiple spaces indeed or. Look at this. This is what is coming on the screen. We have interchanged the sequence. Now there is nicely exactly one space. Yeah. Now that there is exactly one space, why don't we do first and second column for this output? Now, this is better formatted output. The space is an extremely dangerous thing to use as a delimiter. It is good only if you know every line, every column, whenever there is a space, there is only one space. If there are multiple spaces like it was there in the previous case, then there is a problem. So, here again the output will be fine. Yeah. Here if you use 1-3, it will work. Why? Because we know that this is exactly one space. But do we know but this part is exactly one space? Maybe there are 2 spaces, 3 spaces, maybe yeah, at the end of this line inside the marks.txt, at the end of that line there might have been many spaces, end of the line some extra spaces, they are harmless. Somebody might have put many spaces anyway we cannot see. Yeah, that is why something is going wrong. Yeah, so if you, so here there may be some spaces here, some, yeah, this is hard to see on the screen. Yeah, so please use the space as a delimiter very carefully. In our own organization of the data, we always use semicolon. Yeah, semicolon is hardly used for anything else. Colon, semicolon are better delimiters because they are always visible. Whenever they are there, they are visible. Space is this invisible character, how many spaces are there are not visible. That is one question. Another question was, how do you check only the 10th line? How do you cut out the 10th line? Yeah, so let us see this marks. Marks is primes. Yeah. Look, let us look at this. So, there are many lines here. These lines are not numbered. Yeah. So, why do not we say grep? Grep is something we will certainly see tomorrow. Please allow me to be a little fast today. Yeah. Let us see. So grep pattern, pattern to, how do you use grep? Pattern to search in items.txt. Yeah, is there any, there is no word pattern to search in items.txt, that is why nothing has come out. Surely begin line character will be there. Yeah, begin line character is hat, that is why it has shown all the lines. Why do not we try to show all these with line numbers also? Yeah. So, now all line numbers have come on the screen. Yeah. So, believe me, do not feel this too hard. Tomorrow only we will see the advanced usage of grep. All this we will cover tomorrow. Now that this has come on the screen, why do not we grep for the 10th line? How do you look for the 10th line? One way is to just put this 10. But this 10 might have occurred inside some line, yeah, genuinely inside some line that may or may not come. Luckily, no line had 10, but one should ideally be careful and say 10 should occur in the beginning of the line. Yeah, this has come. This is how you can extract out the 10th line. This has come as output, but you may not want the number 10 in the output. How will you do this? Why do not we pipe it to cut? Yeah, cut minus delimiter. What delimiter? Colon. Yeah, and then minus f 2 onwards. This has shown the 10th line without showing the number 10. Yeah, only because many of you asked this doubt, we have done it now. Don't worry, this is just one of the various ways. If you know pipe, if you know cut, grep is anything, we anyway we will teach you tomorrow. You can do using this. SED is something, some streamline editor which will do this even easily, but we are not planning to cover that in that course, in this course. Yeah, by just careful combination of pipes it is possible to do this very very easily. By just using each time output of this, you pipe it to again another command which will look for something whose output can be sent to another pipe. Yes, the output of this is being piped to this command. Output of this command is being piped to cut command, and the final output is coming out precisely as the 10th line. Yeah, that number 10 has been put in here. What is this doing? It is putting line numbers to every line. Yeah, finally, output we do not want that number 10, to be sitting in the line. Yeah, is that okay? Does this answer the doubts of so many people? Okay, let's look at this. Somebody from Mufak Hamza College has asked. I am having two files, two file names. First one consists of 5 columns, second 3 columns. I want to cut the second column in the first and paste it in the third column in the second file. Is it possible? It is impossible that we will say no. If it is not possible, if we do not know now, we will look it up. But all these are very much possible, yeah, by using plain commands. So let us see, but in order to do this, we have to understand paste a little more. We in particular, we have to understand what was the dash we had used. The dash that we had used, and we said it is optional for a particular case, that is no longer optional now. Yeah, when we are using paste, we have 2 input arguments. So why do not we see this slide? Redirection and piping. This particular doubt that has been asked on chat will get answered very soon. Cut minus D space minus F 2 dash marks 1.txt. What is this slash? The slash is just to allow you to continue to write on the next line. Yeah, when that line becomes very long, then we want to be able to continue to type on the next line without pressing the enter command. If you press the enter command, it will get executed. Yeah, now you want to press the enter command but not execute it. So please type slash backslash, I think, and then press the enter command. So then you can continue to type that command here. With a smaller font, of course, the entire thing can be typed on the same line. You can continue, you can try to do that also. What does this do? Paste. You have cut out some marks from the marks1.txt. Second to last column we have cut out using some delimiter, and the output we have put to some temporary file. Temporary file we have hence copied in some temp directory. Temp is some directory that is there on all Linux computers, where several such junk temp files automatically generated are all put there. Now then what we can do, we can paste students here and that temporary file. This particular doubt somebody had asked in the chat is exactly like this. Now instead of doing all that, why do not we use pipe? Pipe is being used. So the output, instead of being redirected to this file, is being piped to the paste command. After all, this was generated only for paste, and there is no other purpose of this. Some temporary file, because you did not know where to keep that standard output, so you wrote it to temp, some file there. Now this paste, unfortunately, paste, whenever you want to paste one file, another file, you need 2 files. Yeah, paste requires 2 arguments. These are all options. One argument is coming from a file. Second argument, where is it coming? It's being piped. Yeah. Now paste, you have to tell whatever is being piped, is it the first argument or second argument for the paste command. For the paste command, 2 input arguments, 2 file names are required. One of them has been avoided carefully because of the pipe. The other one is provided from the file itself. In paste, as I said, if you interchange the sequence of files, then it will paste the other way. So you have to, this dash is playing a very key role here, because there are 2 file arguments to be given. Dash will tell you whatever is being piped, it will serve as the first file argument or second file argument. Yeah, so the first solution uses redirection, second solution uses piping. So whoever has asked this question, I strongly encourage you to try this using paste. One of them perhaps has to be written into a file. Whether one of them can be avoided or not is something I will check up and tell. It might be hard, but it might be possible. Yeah. So dash is playing a role for that. We'll just quickly take a question from INCC Pune. Yeah, please ask.
Can we use the cut command for cutting the columns and changing the sequence? Like for example, there is a 10 columns are there, and I want to cut the column number 3, column number 1, column number 5 in the same sequence. Will it be possible to display in that format?
If I understand, the question is, you take a file, cut only the first, third and fifth columns, and it will be shown on the screen. That is what it will certainly do.
No. I want to cut the column number 1, 3, and 5, but it's supposed in this. I want to change the sequence. I want to display the column number 5 first, then 1, and then 3.
So, if you want to interchange the sequence of columns, see there is only one buffer. Yeah, there is whatever can be piped, it is like a buffer. There is only one buffer. Now you have 1, 3, 5. What is, if there are, if you are not, if the delimiter is not a space, then this is a easier thing to do. If the delimiter is not a space, if it is colon for example, best is to paste it. Yeah, best is to paste it.
Actually I tried it, but for example, when you do the cut command, and if you specify the column, if you specify the column 5, comma 1, comma 3, if you put the command like column in the column, we can put 5, comma 1, comma 3, it will cut these three columns, but it will display in 1, 3, 4, 5.
Ah, yeah.
So you cannot change the display sequence.
Sure. So yeah, thank you indeed for checking this. So so the question from IMCC Pune is another command. You mean no, the challenge is using cut, paste, pipe, we should do it. That's possible. Yeah, just requires are there any other questions before we do this question in little more detail? Are there any other questions?
No.
Okay, thank you. So the question from IMCC Pune is that we want to interchange two columns. How to do that? Yeah, if you can interchange, you can do many other things. So let us just look at marks. So here are four columns. So what he already tried was minus D, minus F. Suppose he wants only first and third column. Not just that, first and third columns have to be displayed as third column first and then first column. Yeah, one very obvious good thing to check is you put 3, 1 of what file name, I forgot, marks. So it has shown first and third column only. So what sequence you put these numbers does not matter. That is the first thing we can note. Why do not we do like this? Why do not we pipe it? Paste to what? Marks 1.txt and dash. So it has put some additional things. Yeah. Now we can also, we can interchange this as soon as we put the dash here. So at least whatever you wanted, you are able to put it earlier. Yeah, for example, if you wanted the third column to come first, you can do it like this. Yeah, and now is when you can take first and second column of the output. Of the output, if you take the first and second column, the space is potentially a problem. But why don't we cut minus D? Yeah, so 1, 2. So these are tab limit delimited. Yeah, this has shown the first and third. Yeah, this is what was wanted. This is the third and first column of this file. Yeah, but why have we put only one here? Because as I said, this particular strange character is not space. It is a tab character. Yeah, they are invisible and misleading, yeah, because it is tab character, we do not understand whether it is space or tab. So just first column happened to be enough. So this was indeed the first and third column of the original file. Yeah, if it is space, then there is a problem, as I said. But this a careful combination of these can be used to interchange the sequence. So Prashant Dave here, who will help much later on in this course also, has told me just now that when you use paste, default paste is going to put the tab character at the end of each line of the first file. Of the first file, tab character is going to be put. Yeah, if you do not want tab character, but you want the space character to be put, then paste with some additional options will help you do this. So please see help paste for this then the space will cause less of a problem. Of course, luckily the space was not at all a problem in this file to begin with, that is also required. Yeah, this is how one can interchange the first and third columns. First, third and fifth also repeatedly one can do like this again and again. Yeah, any other questions before we see a little more in detail about the redirection and piping? So redirection, standard output, yeah, stream goes to the display, that is the default, as I was saying, not always what we need. So the first solution redirects outputs to a file, that is a greater than sign. Yeah, double greater than sign, as I said, appends to the specified location. If that file is not, does not exist, it will create it. What about standard input? Standard input is the keyboard. Default, whatever we are supposed to type is supposed to come from the keyboard. You can make it come from a file for certain commands like cut, like paste, they all have to come from a file. But there are certain other commands for which this input is supposed to come from the keyboard. Instead of coming from the keyboard, you can use this other symbol, this is less than. Yeah, that time all the commands that you are supposed to put in from the keyboard will come from the file 1. What is supposed to be in file 1? Whatever you are supposed to type, the standard input, instead of coming from the keyboard, will come from the file 1 command. There's also a third one called standard error. Yeah, for many commands you want to know whether there is an error or not. Yeah, especially when we are writing bash scripts to check your scripts, that time we want to have a count whether there is an error or not in the execution. Why this is required? Otherwise you might have an infinite loop and our program will not exit out of our checking process because your program is not running properly. So that is when standard error is also really important. This also can be seen in detail. So this is something we already saw. So the first 1 greater than means standard output, 2 greater than means the standard error will go to this particular file. Yeah, 1 greater than means the standard output is getting directed to that particular file, whatever file you write here. Yeah, the default means what? Typically we are interested in just the output, not much in the error. At least in so many years now I have never been interested in the error, but now for the bash script checking, Shrikant, Prashant are also paying attention to that. So this is a symbol for that. 2 greater than means an error. Piping is also something we have already been seeing. Yeah, this vertical line is called a pipe. Tab completion. Yeah, so we already saw this. So tab, extremely useful for completing something. So use tab, as far as possible use tab, that way spelling mistakes will not occur. If you know a file exists and tab is not completing it, means you have already made a mistake in the spelling. Yeah, 2 times means it will list all the possibilities because there is an ambiguity, it has not completed, then it lists the possibilities. You can resolve the possibility by typing this one letter more and then typing the tab command. So tab will complete different things. So if you have already typed the command and the file name is to be typed, then tab will complete the file name. If it is supposed to be, if it is a CD, for a CD command, CD, what is the input argument to the CD command? You will not change directory into a file, you will change directory only into a directory. So it will, tab will automatically complete only to directory names. Yeah, if it is a command you want to execute, then it will look for only executable file names and also all the commands that are available. Yeah, if you tilde, yeah, so tilde is one thing that we did not spend much time, we will just quickly see that now. Tilde will try to complete to all possible user names on that computer. Host names, at, yeah, where are these host names? This also we can spend a few minutes now. Variable names, dollar, we already saw this, we saw home variable, we saw old PWD variable, also PWD variable we saw. Yeah, history. Okay, so we will just quickly see all these different users, etc. So look, there is only one directory, test directory. If you try to change the directory, this is the only possibility. Is this really the only possibility? can there be a, there are two more possibilities. The CD from here can have also CD dot dot. Yeah, let us see what happens. Default, it is not trying to do CD dot dot, nor is it doing CD dot. Of course, you can also go to directly go to another directory which is absolute path name. Yeah, that also is not default. You do, it will complete only test directory. That is not always the case. Yeah, for example, another command for cat. Cat, after cat, you are supposed to give a file name. Which file name do you want to give? We have not decided yet. Why don't we press tab? Tab once, nothing has happened. Another one, it has given all these potential completions. Yeah, amongst these, we are supposed to resolve this conflict now. If you, there are more, it's not one screen full. So why don't we type P? After P, we complete. It is completing to primes. Starting from P, there is only one completion. Luckily, if there were more completions, for example, M. From M, there are up to marks. There is only one completion. But then from there on, there is one marks 1.txt or marks.txt. We can resolve this by typing only one letter. Why don't we just type 1 and then press tab again? Now it is complete. That is as far as cat command is concerned. But for CD, let us come back to CD. CD, you are supposed to give a directory name. So clearly, marks you type and you try, we know there is a marks1.txt, but for CD command it will not work. Yeah. For CD, you just type tab, only one test directory is the only directory in that particular current directory. Yeah. So what about executable names? So you might have a file name. For example, grep, GRE. After GRE command, we already use the grep command. Why don't we press tab? Yeah, so P we didn't have to press. Why? Because starting from GRE, there's only one. Why don't we see from GR? From GR, there are so many commands. At the command, when you are typing a command, before you type the space, there are many completions. All these commands are potential completions. So why don't we type one more? So we see that if we type P, there are some commands. So now if you type P, then there are only this many more completions. We can, if you type U, then the ambiguity will be resolved fully. Yeah, I type U and that is how this happened. Now what about usernames? Now what about you, who are all the users here? Yeah, so why don't we go to CD? Tilde means home. Yeah, tilde means home of whom now? Whose home? Yeah, when I say I am going home, just tilde means going home. It means my home. We are in this home, but we could also be interested in some other home. F, we already saw that FOSSI is a directory, is a username. So F and then, so it is not completing. So not for CD, for something else it might. Huh? There is a finger. No. So where is this username relevant? Yeah, so for finger is not installed. So finger used to be a command. Yeah, what am I thinking about? So there in the slides there is some usernames. Yeah, usernames. So executable names, I've given you an example. Directory names, I've given you an example. I am trying to look for an example where tilde you type and type tab, it will try to complete usernames. For that, I have to think of a command which requires usernames as its argument. So, which command requires username as its argument? Yeah, finger. For those who used to know finger, finger used to be an example of a command. You can finger some person and see when the person last log in. Yeah, you can see many other such information. That person's phone number, some such useful information, if he has kept, that is also available on finger. But nowadays, for security reasons, that's being removed. That's why finger is also not there in the default installation. Finger can be installed, of course. Host names, yeah. Host names are typically with @. Why? Because you say user @ so and so host name. Yeah, like login names, user @ so and so email address.com. So host names is what we can see. For user names, I should look for a good example. Yeah, so why don't we see host names? Why don't we do SSH? SSH is a command for secure shell login into another server, yeah, Belur at so many servers. These are the various servers that are there in the database of this computer, yeah. We typed at, after at, when we press tab, there are so many servers. Why do not I say Bhairav? B, just B completion is Bhairav. Why? Because B is the only completion according to the list of hosts. Where is this list now? Yeah, incidentally, I happen to know this because I have to typically. So, these are all the various hosts listed in /etc/hosts. Yeah, this would be there on everybody's computer. All these various hosts is what it is trying to complete after you put at. Why at? Because when you do SSH typically requires all these server names, all other server names into which we could do secure shell login from our computer. Yeah, so at is an example for that. What about variable names? Yeah, echo, dollar, after dollar, there are many variables you can complete. We already saw h. From starting from h, home is not the only one. Just because we saw home variable does not mean there is, that is the only variable starting with h. Yeah. So, from echo is a command for echoing out various things. Yeah. Echo can be used also for seeing the value of a particular shell variable. So, h, o. Now, again, home is not the unique completion. You can type host name. Home anyway you all know, that is the name of this particular computer. Yeah, you can also see host type, it is some i386, yeah, perhaps this is some processor number or something. So, these are the this Linux kernel number, is it? So, these are the different completions. You can also see echo all the shell variables. This is something I encourage you all to do. There are, if the number of completions is too many, then it will say there are 108 possibilities. Are you sure all of them should be displayed? Just pressing yes will display them. Yeah, these are all the various shell variables. Yeah, you can see that echo username is also a shell variable. Now, these are the different shell variables. Tab completion after you put a dollar will automatically try to complete two shell variables. After dollar, shell variable is what most likely you are interested in, and hence tab completion will work for that purpose. So, okay, so tab completion is a good place for us to stop. Shell variables is what we have seen. The next topic is again a very important topic which will require a good amount of time. We'll continue from history tomorrow morning at sharp 9 a.m. Okay, thank you very much. Questions also on all the topics we will start taking tomorrow morning. Okay, thank you.